accountable of shooting his wife in this parking lot left behind a note in his truck that said, quote, he had anger in his heart. That anger boiled over. Stephanie Willard's father had nothing to say and asked us to leave when we tried to get reaction to today's murder-suicide that left her and her estranged husband dead. Alan Cawthon is a neighbor who lives a few doors down from the Willard's home. The news stunned him.
That's tough. Everything's happening bad now.
Ridgeland police say shortly before noon, 52-year-old Billy Willard went into his estranged wife's job at Exam 1 office on North Park Drive to confront her.
She was inside the office with other co-workers. As she exited the building to talk to her estranged husband, she was shot multiple times with a high-caliber firearm.
Stephanie Willard later died at UMC, while Billy Willard died on the scene after turning the gun on himself. Police say the couple had been going through some troubling times and had split.
We've never had any problems out here whatsoever with any violence or any type of crime in this area. So it's somewhat a little bit unnerving.
Folks at nearby businesses say the shooting was too close for comfort.
Well, it scared me. I mean, you don't know what way he was shooting. I mean, if he'd been shooting our way, it could have come straight through our window and killed us. And it's very frightening.
And even in the Willard's neighborhood, Cawthon says he never noticed anything out of the ordinary that would have led to this crime scene.
Yeah, it's a quiet neighborhood. I mean, it ain't nothing really goes on here a lot.
Originally, police are trying to determine why Billy would want to kill his wife. Police say the couple had no prior history of any type of domestic-related incidents here in Ridgeland or in Pearl, where they lived. We're live in Ridgeland tonight. Andrew Kinsey, 16 WAPT News.
Now, Andrew, what did that neighbor, what were they able to tell you about that couple?
The neighborhood, it was really quiet tonight. Mostly everyone there was still in a shock process. That neighbor had never talked directly to that couple, just lived in that neighborhood.
All right, Andrew, thank you so much for that live report.